Why are you delaying your S4HANA conversion project? Do you know what is the single biggest blocker for a typical S4HANA conversion project? In this video, I will try to answer those two questions. Hi, I'm Michał Krawczyk and I'm an SAP mentor and I wrote 6 books about SAP. First, I will try to show you what a typical S4HANA conversion process looks like. But no worries, very briefly, because we all more or less know that. Then, I will try to pinpoint the biggest blocker in a typical S4HANA conversion project. Next, I will try to show you how you can solve the biggest blocker within a single day. Finally, we will go through Int4 IFTT demo, where I will try to prove it. Let's start with defining what a typical S4HANA conversion process is. So basically, it's a move from your old SAP ERP system to the S4HANA system. And by the way, for those of you that don't know, this is an actual telephone. What are the steps? What are the typical steps for an S4HANA conversion project? So first, we need to start with the preparation phase, where we check the system requirements, we run the maintenance planner, we do the pre-checks, and then comes the realization phase, where we need to run the software update manager, we have to do the database conversion, we have to do the data migration, and hopefully, if everything is fine, we can do the go live. But didn't we miss any of the critical phases of a typical project? Of course we did, because we have to test our solution. And now the question is, what is the single biggest blocker for a typical S4HANA conversion project? It's the fear. People are afraid that their old processes will stop working after the conversion. Imagine, you have to ship 100 trucks from your warehouse, but the system stops working. You cannot load your trucks, and the customers will not receive the product today. Would you like to experience anything like that? If not, you can never forget about testing. Surprisingly, what we found is that both the time and the number of resources for a typical S4HANA conversion project will be different than with a greenfield project. There will be less time and much less resources. So what's the challenge? Decrease the number of functional and business resources, and at the same time, you need to do more testing. But how does that sound? Crazy, insane, or just plain contradictory? Of course it is, but only if you test everything manually. So what is the solution here? You need to fully automate your regression testing. Typically, for conversions, we copy the production system to the test system, on which we would perform the test conversion. After that, we can start doing the testing. However, since our new S4HANA system is a copy of the production, we have all of the transactions and all of the master data available. What if there would be a way to rerun all of those transactions after the conversion and then compare the data and the business objects created before the conversion with the business objects created after the conversion? Would that be a good regression test? Currently, many modern systems are highly connected with other systems. That means that the number of transactions which are directly entered in your SAP system is actually much, much smaller than the total number of transactions that exist in your SAP system. Think about your EDI partner. Let's imagine you're a company selling food or beverages. In this case, most of your sales orders coming from retailers like Walmart, Tesco, or Lidl would be automatically inserted in your system with the use of an integration technology, let's say iDocs. What if there would be a way to rerun all of those transactions and messages and compare the business objects created before S4HANA conversion with the objects created after S4HANA conversion? Would that cover some of your fears? Would that decrease the number of functional and business users available for testing and at the same time increase the number of tests? I think so. One of our customers was preparing for the first S4HANA conversion in Switzerland. But they were really, really scared. Even though we gave them the best S4HANA conversion experts, obviously the trust had to be built. Luckily for us, most of their business processes were starting outside of the SAP. So they decided to use our tool, Int4 IFTT, to rerun all of the existing messages, all of the iDocs, and compare the data before the S4HANA conversion with the data and business objects created after the S4HANA conversion. In this way, they reduce the number of resources required to do the testing, and at the same time, they increase the number of tests. The process was quick and smooth, because we only had to rerun the data from a single month. After it was done, the customer realized that it's safe to move to the next phase of the project. So we've completely eliminated the fear factor. Obviously, the customer was also very happy that we managed to do the testing so quickly. Finally, it's time to see the demo. In the demo, I would like to show you how we can rerun a set of transactions with the use of Int4 IFTT. What we will do exactly is that we will take 20 IDOCs, which created sales orders. We will try to rerun them and reprocess them with the use of Int4 IFTT and compare the business objects before and after the conversion. Hopefully, we will do that in less than 1 minute. Come on, please join me to see the demo. As a first step, we need to find the IDOC messages which created the sales orders before the test system was converted to S4HANA. We can do it from transaction WO2. We need to select here 20 inbound IDOCs. Once we have the IDOC numbers, we can open the Int4 IFTT application to create the test cases. We can do that from Int4 IFTT cockpit. Next, we need to select the folder when we want to store our test cases and create them. I will copy and paste the IDOC numbers and press the Save button. Int4 IFTT will automatically create 20 test cases from the existing IDOCs, and it will also use the pre-delivered configuration object called backend sales orders, which can be used for testing the incoming sales orders. In the next step, we need to run all 20 test cases. During the run, Int4 IFTT will take the reference IDOC and repose them once more. After that, it will compare the reference sales orders created before the S4HANA conversion with the new sales orders created after the S4HANA conversion. As a result, we will get a report showing the differences between the posted sales orders. As you can see, the run took only a few seconds, and in that time, Int4 IFTT posted 20 new sales orders and compared them with the reference sales orders. It seems that all of the new sales orders are exactly the same as the reference sales orders. We can also verify the results on the field level, selecting one of the test cases. As you can see in the details, all of the fields of the new sales orders, dark green, in the SAP database are exactly the same as the reference sales orders, light green, in the SAP database. What Int4 IFTT did was to post new sales orders on the basis of the reference IDOC messages and compared it with the old sales orders which got posted before the conversion. The whole process for 20 sales orders took only a few seconds. And you can use the same method to retest hundreds of your most critical integration scenarios and get the results within a few minutes. The Int4 IFTT comparison report can be later on validated by business and functional users as a proof that the system after the S4HANA conversion is working exactly in the same way as it was before the conversion. This kind of fully automated testing can eliminate the fear factor from any person responsible for testing the S4HANA system. Thank you for watching the demo. If you'd like to find out more about our testing approach, please visit our website, int4.com/testing.